Did you know that there are people who believe that they can be faithful to God and go to heaven without being an active part of the body of Christ? There are those who say that they want Christ, but they do not want the church. They see the importance of having a relationship with Christ, but they want nothing to do with their brothers and sisters in Christ. Well, what this is showing is a half-hearted devotion. It shows that they have enough recognition of their spiritual need that they want to accept Christ, they want to have a relationship with Him, but they don't want to go so far as to actually becoming an active part of the family of God. But the book of Acts tells us about the history of the New Testament church. It talks about the very first ones that were saved by the blood of Jesus. It tells us what transpired after their salvation came. It tells us how they were saved. We read about this in Acts chapter 2. They repented and they were baptized. As a result of this, the Lord added them to the church. Now we recognize from this that whenever we become a child of God, whether our desire is to be a part of the church or not, the Lord is going to add us to the church. But there are responsibilities that are placed upon us as children of God toward the congregation that we are a part of. We read in the second chapter of Acts in verse 47, "Praising God and having favor with all people, the Lord added to the church daily such as should be saved." Well, we notice in this reference that those who were saved did not join a church, as many in the religious world today believe they must do, but they were added to the church by the Lord. Then Paul, right in the book of Ephesians 2 and verse 16, he says, "And that he might reconcile both unto God in one body by the cross, having slain the enmity thereby." Also in Colossians 1 and verse 18, "And he is the head of the body, the church, who is the beginning, the firstborn from the dead, that in all things he might have the preeminence." Notice in these verses it's showing us the fact that the Lord wants all to come together and be a part of His church. We cannot join the church, but when we obey the gospel of Christ, God adds us to His church. Now notice in all of this conversation, it's showing us that if we want to be a child of God, we have to be a part of the church. We are automatically added to the church if we are children of God. Well, Paul, through the Holy Spirit, writes again in Ephesians 1, verses 22 and 23. He says, "And hath put all things under his feet, and gave him to be the head over all things to the church, which is his body, the fullness of him that filleth all in all." Would it not be wonderful if everyone who claimed to be a Christian, everyone who claimed to be religious, would actually obey the gospel plan of salvation, would do so in the way that the New Testament prescribes, and then would take an active role in the Lord's church? Would that not be wonderful? But so many either want nothing to do with the church. Oh yes, they believe that they're Christians. They believe that they're going to be saved, but they want nothing to do with the church. Or they look for a church for reasons other than what is in keeping with the will of God. They look for a church because someone in their family belongs to a particular religious group, or because a certain group agrees with their preconceived notions about Scripture. But we must be willing to go to the Bible, study to learn what God's will is, And then we must be willing to change our lives and to change our thought processes to conform to the will of God. The Bible is the Word of God, and we must accept it. And if we truly love Christ, then we will keep His commandments, even those commandments that pertain to His church. Friends, we thank you for joining us for our program today, and have a blessed day.